Nancy Couquet works at a community college in Maryland, coordinating technical education programs. She's worked in education most of her career and loves her job. But at 65 years old, she'd imagined retiring by now.
I can't afford to retire. I could never make the payments.
Payments for student loans she took out for her son Andrew about a decade ago. She pays around $500 a month on the nearly $75,000 she owes on loans she took out and others she co-signed with her son. By her math, she'll probably be paying on her loans alone for another 11 years.
Even if I started drawing on my retirement and Social Security together, I still wouldn't have enough monthly to make those payments. It's certainly not where I hope to be at this stage in life.
The number of Americans age 60 and older with student loan debt quadrupled between 2005 and 2015 to nearly 3 million. And the average amount they owe has nearly doubled from about $12,000 to almost $24,000.
There's a number of factors that contribute to why the number of older borrowers is increasing.
Attorney Persis Yu directs the Student Loan Borrower Assistance Project at the National Consumer Law Center in Boston.
Student loans are structured to be paid over a very long period of time. They have no statute of limitations, which means that they follow you. They can follow you till you die, literally. And so there are a lot of borrowers who are out there who still have their own student loan debts from the 70s, from the 80s.
I think originally it was like $27,000.
64-year-old Annette Palais of Boston is still paying about $300 a month for the loan she took out 20 years ago to pursue graduate degrees in American Studies, a loan she expects to be paying for another 10 years. She worked for nonprofits serving children and the elderly, but her income never reached the level she'd hoped.
I'm making now what I made in the 80s. I'm making about $42,000 a year.
So when you went back to grad school, you assumed you'd be making a lot more money than that.
Oh, yes, absolutely. I mean, if I was making that money with a bachelor's degree in the 80s, I assumed that, you know, with a master's, I'd do a little bit better.
Folks with student loan debt typically save less than folks without student loan debt. And then once they're in retirement, if they are repaying loans, certainly that is a liability that they wouldn't otherwise have to pay for when they're on a fixed and limited income.
Because of her debt and the high cost of living in Boston, Palais says she has little retirement savings. She recently retired but can't afford to keep living in Boston, so she moved to New Mexico, where it's cheaper to live. But even still, her expected $1,000 a month Social Security check won't cover her expenses.
Rent will be $620 plus utilities, and then there's the school loan, and there goes the $1,000. So I will be doing some part-time work.
How do you feel about that? I mean, is this what you pictured retirement being?
Well, you know, at this point, I'm not so terribly concerned because I'm still young enough to do so. What concerns me is when I'm in my 70s or 80s, hopefully, if I get there, I may not be able to do that.
Like Palais, 27% of older Americans with student loans borrowed for their own education. But most, more than 70%, borrowed for their children's or grandchildren's education. People like Nancy Couquet. Couquet, who's divorced, took out about $46,000 in her name and co-signed for around $34,000 more with her son Andrew, who graduated from the University of South Carolina in 2008.
I entered into that now, as I, in hindsight, without nearly enough information, and didn't know what I didn't know about financial aid. It's vastly different from when I went to school. I didn't have to borrow to go to school.
Couquet obtained about half of the $46,000 she borrowed for her son's education through a federal loan program called Parent Plus. The number of Parent Plus borrowers has grown by 60% since 2005 to 3.5 million Americans. The National Consumer Law Center says some families can borrow more than they can afford under Parent Plus, because the program lets them borrow as much as the college says they need without verifying their income.
At no point is the school or the federal government seeing if the family can afford to repay this loan.
Is anyone along the way saying, hey, if you take out this amount of money, this is what it's going to mean for you? Is anybody kind of giving a warning to families?
So, you know, there is some very minimal counseling that is required when folks take out federal loans. The other component is a lot of these families don't have a lot of other options because education is expensive. So a lot of families feel trapped and they feel like they have to take out this because they want to provide for their kids and they want their kids to have a better future.
And that's exactly what Nancy Couquet wanted for her son. She says she wasn't too worried about Andrew's ability to pay off his loans once he graduated.
I kept telling him, and I thought this would be true, is this degree will give you a career that you can pay that off. Turns out not to be the case. He graduated in 2008 in the depths of the Great Recession, and jobs were hard to come by.
After graduating with a degree in sports management, Andrew has worked steadily, even taking on second jobs at night and on the weekends. But his earnings haven't been enough to keep up with the $400 and $500 payments on the roughly $45,000 he took out, so Nancy's been paying the loans she co-signed. I spoke to Andrew over Google Hangout.
I did not think that it would be this hard to pay student loans. I definitely went in to school thinking that I'll get a decent paying job.
Andrew recently landed a higher paying job and wants to help pay the loans his mom co-signed.
I don't want her to be suffering for it any longer than she has to, just for doing a nice thing and co-signing on a loan. Would I do it all over again? No, I would not do it again. I would stick around, I'd stay home for a couple years and go to a community college near my house.
In the meantime, Nancy says the loan payments are weighing her down.
It governs everything I do, every decision I make. It all revolves around making sure that I have that money to make that payment every single month.
Nancy has consolidated and gotten slightly lower interest rates on some of the loans, but she expects she'll need to work part-time after she retires. And she's also considering moving to Montana, where the cost of living is cheaper.
My life isn't going to be the way that I'd hoped that it would be. It just simply isn't going to be.
There's also this catch with federal loans and older borrowers who can't pay them off. The U.S. Treasury can garnish their Social Security benefits. In fact, between 2002 and 2015, the number of Americans having Social Security, disability, and retirement benefits garnished because of unpaid loans increased almost 500% to 173,000.
Who do I go and get this money back from?
It happened to 55-year-old Manuel Roberts of Brooklyn, New York. He paid off most all of the $13,000 he borrowed to attend the University of Southern California in the 1980s. But after losing a job, he defaulted on the last $3,000 and then sustained a severe head injury in 2002.
Then I was injured in street violence. I was a victim of a violent crime. I was in a coma for 2 weeks or so.
Roberts received Social Security disability checks for $1,300 every month. But the government began deducting $200 from every check for the defaulted loan.
I was already in a bad situation. It's plain to see they just made it worse.
The Social Security deductions pushed Roberts to the verge of the federal poverty line. It turns out there's a program for people disabled like Roberts to get their loans eliminated. But many people don't know about it.
So no one ever said, hey, mm-hmm. we notice you're getting disability income. You might be also eligible for a disability discharge. This mm-hmm. could stop.
No, that was never brought to me by anybody.
Roberts' attorney helped him get the disability discharge and is also helping him and six people with similar stories sue the heads of the Federal Department of Education, Treasury, and the Social Security Administration, alleging that they don't do enough to let people know about the disability discharge program. The Federal Department of Education declined an on-camera interview with PBS NewsHour Weekend and did not respond to written questions. The Social Security Administration and the Treasury Department also did not comment. U.S. Senators Ron Wyden of Oregon and Sherrod Brown of Ohio are sponsoring legislation to eliminate the practice of garnishing Social Security benefits for unpaid loans, but the bill's gone nowhere so far. Nancy Couquet's Social Security checks won't be at risk because she keeps up with her monthly student loan payments. For other parents trying to figure out how to pay for college now, she has this advice.
I would strongly encourage them to become educated in every aspect of financial aid. Talk to the college financial aid people. I didn't do that. That's a huge mistake. I made assumptions that turned out not to be true. And just mine is a cautionary tale.